Hi guys, it's day 178 of the national lockdown here in South Africa, and it's the last day of level 2. Tomorrow we'll move on to level 1, where you can shop for alcohol from Monday to Friday between 9 and 5. Our curfew is now at 12 o'clock. You can do international flights. I think that's happening in October. I think I already told you what you can do. So yesterday I went to the waterfront with my friends and family, and today my mom was going to the shops with her neighbor. So my mom was wearing a mask, and then the neighbor came out and wore a mask. No, it wasn't. She wasn't wearing a mask. They got in the car and she was still wearing her mask, which she doesn't do. She hasn't done that in the past. And my mom asked the neighbor, why are you wearing the mask? And the reason why she's wearing the mask is because she was at the waterfront. So I was like, she's wearing the mask because you went to the waterfront. But she never wore the mask when we went to Simonstown. Or the fact that she went to Deep River with another neighbor. Or the fact that they've gone to Fisher, to Nootuk. Have gone to places where people don't wear masks and people do wear masks. So what would be the difference of actually going to the waterfront? Is waterfront dirty? I mean, all you see is the locals. It's only locals walking around here because there's no one from the other outside countries. It just baffles my mind of how people are just so narrow-minded when it comes to things. And how uneducated they are, and not actually having a brain to think. I mean, just think about it. Just imagine if we were all infected at the waterfront. My household, my friend's household, there would have been another wave, which I find extremely stupid. But bear in mind, a lot of people say that South Africa is going to have a second wave, which I don't understand. How can you have a second wave? Why would there be a second wave? I would think if there was a second wave, it would have hit us by now. What would have been the cause of the second wave? I'm just finding people just believing what they're seeing and not asking the questions to give them the right answers. It's really, I wouldn't say sickening, can't say that. I just find it really, really irritating. I'm irritated. I am fed up. I am sick and tired of doing these videos every single damn day. It's becoming a chore now, but I have to do these videos. I have to show you what it's like to be in a pandemic for 178 days. The National Disaster Act is now full swing until the 15th of October. I certainly hope things will be much better after that, because how long is this going to be? Are we going to be on a lockdown for a year? Or two, because the likelihood that the virus will come back, but hopefully by then we will have some sort of a medication that will actually fight the coronavirus. I just find it so weird that no one actually has found a cure. I mean, how many diseases have we been fighting over the 100 years? It just gets a bit too much now. This is 178, and I will see you tomorrow.